Hello everyone, this is Barka Technical Solution and I am Fed Doswam, and in this video we are going to see how to create a Larson effect that you are watching right now. So let's go to our computer screen and see how we can actually create the circuit here. So the circuit is very simple. We are going to connect 6 LED. We are connecting 6 LED because we have 6 PWM pin in our Arduino. Those are 3, 5, 6, 9, 10, and 11. The ones with this tilde sign, which is here, as you can see, it is indicating the PWM. So that's why we are going to use 6 LEDs, and the cathode of the LEDs are connected to the resistors, which are connected to the ground rail of our Arduino, of our breadboard, and which is connected to the ground pin of our Arduino. And the anode of our LEDs are connected, so the anodes are connected to the PWM pins of our Arduino. So as you can see, this one, the first one, is connected to the pin number 3, the green. The second one, the orange one, is connected to the 5, and respectively everything is connected serially and sequentially. So now let's go and see how we can actually program this to actually create that effect. So the programming here is the main thing here. So now let's go. So now we're in our Arduino IDE. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create an array of all of our pins that are connected to the LEDs. So this is the array we have created here. So the pins are 3, 5, 6, 9, 10, and 11, and we are going to create two variables, which are count and timer. So the count is actually, we have set it to 0, and the timer is 30. So the timer is actually will be working as the delay, as you can see here, the delay, and we have written here the timer. So if we want to change the timing or the delay time, we can change it from simply here, and all the program will be resetted to that delay time. So that's why we are going to create this timer. So now we are going to our setup part. So here what I have done is where I have created a for loop, so that we don't have to write 6 or 7 lines to actually make all of our pins to output. What I have done is I have created the for loop, and in that for loop I have set the pin modes to output by simply referring to the array that we have created, and the count will be changing as we have set it here. So the count will be starting from 0 to less than 6, which means to 5. So here in our array, this is the index 0 and this is the index 5. So all of that will be rotating here as the loop goes on, and all of them will be set to output. Then we come to our loop part. So in our loop part, what I have done is I have done the almost the same thing. I have just created an for loop from here to here. Then what I have done is I have in the digital write parameter, instead of including the pin number itself, I have again included the array that we have created, so that we don't have to write every pin number by its own or every time. Then I have made them all to high, so they will be all turned on. So they will be on for this part of the loop. Then in the second part of the loop, which is this one, all of this light will be turning off. And then I have done the same thing in this for loop also. So the difference here is that this first loop is counting as an increment. So what it will do is the LEDs will be turning on from 3 to 5 to 6 to 9 to 10, then to pin number 11. And in the second part, it is decrementing. So it will go backward, it will start from 11 and will end at 3. So that will actually create the effect that we want to see. So that's one of the way that we can actually create the Larson effect. But if you want to make the animation more smooth, then we can actually look at another. This is our second program that we are going to write. So with this program, what we will do is we will be actually using the PWM pins in this program. In the first program, we actually didn't use the benefit of the PWM pins. So now we are going to use that. And what we are going to do is we are going to make the transition look much more smoother. And as you can see here, that there is an extra light that is actually lighting up, and that is actually a little bit dimmer than the main LED that is very bright. So to do that, what we are going to do is the basic things are all the same. In the loop, it is in the loop panel, there we are actually using the same for loop. But what we are actually changing is we are going to use the analog write function in this program, and instead of declaring high or low, so now we are going to actually define how much bright or dim the LED will be, which is written here. So the highest it can go is 255 and the lowest is 0. So we are going to decide anything in between these two numbers. So what I have done is, like the first one which was set to high, I have defined it to 127, which is 50% of PWM. Then we are going to set another then we are going to take another LED and we are going to also make it turn on, make it much more dimmer than our main LED, which is this one. So what we are going to do is we are going to add plus 1 to this count. So what it will do, if the count is now 0, so the 0 means the pin number 3 is now on. So that will be on with 50% of the PWM, and the second LED that will be on is count plus 1. So 0 plus 1 means 1, which is the 5. So the next LED will be also on, but it will be much more dimmer than our dominant or the main LED. So that will actually create a smooth transition like effect when this Larson effect will be actually going on very fast. So that's why we need to actually add this line. Then just like the previous program, we're going to set it to 0, which is similar to low. So now the LED is off, which is this one, the LED number 3, which is off. And the second LED, what will happen is that it will be now in our second iteration of the loop. The second LED, which was here, will now come to here, and it will be now much more brighter. And the next LED, which is 6, will now be on, but with a very dim amount of light. And the same thing will happen here, it will be in reverse order. So that's all in our program. So thank you everyone for watching the video. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe for more videos like this.